Hi, today we are preparing chicken biryani and an easy egg curry. Now, I won't claim that this is a quick chicken biryani recipe because we all know chicken biryani takes time and patience to prepare. But I can assure you that this recipe is easy to prepare and it does not have many steps involved. So even if you are a beginner, you can confidently try out this recipe. Let's check out the ingredients. We require 4 tomatoes each for 1 cup of basmati rice and 2 onions each for 1 cup of basmati rice. Next, we require ginger, garlic and green chilies. Take nearly 20 cloves of garlic for each glass of rice and proportionately smaller piece of ginger. Next, we require a bowl of pudina and a bowl of coriander leaves. Let's now go through the spices we require. We are taking spices in 2 sets, one set to cook the rice and the other set to grind the masala. Let's first go through the spices we require to cook the rice. Here we require fennel seeds and poppy seeds and a small piece of cinnamon, a star anise and bay leaf. Now let's go through the spices we require to grind for the masala. Here be very mindful of the quantity of spices you take. Because we are grinding these spices, they'll release a very strong flavor in the masala. So if you take proportionately larger quantity of spices, then you'll not be able to actually enjoy the flavor of rice and chicken in the biryani. Here I am preparing for 2.5 cups of basmati rice, but I'm still not taking the same quantity of spices as I've shown in the video. So here you require only 1 small piece of cinnamon, 3 cloves, 3 cardamoms, a small piece of nutmeg, and some fennel seeds for 1 cup of rice. Next, we require salt and eggs to prepare egg curry. Here, I am taking 2.5 cups of basmati rice and 1.5 kg of chicken. First, we'll start with cooking the chicken. For this, let's roughly chop the onions and tomatoes. I'm taking just half an onion and 1 tomato. Let's take the chicken, which are nicely cleaned and cut, in a pressure cooker. To this, let's add our chopped tomatoes and onions and some salt. Now give them a good mix. Now close the pressure cooker, heat it and wait for one whistle to come up. Here we'll be grinding the masala in 2 batches. For the first batch, let's add our spices. This is the second set of spices that I showed we require to grind the masala. Next, we'll add in garlic, green chilies and ginger. Roughly chop the green chilies and ginger so it will grind easily. To this, let's roughly chop our onions, add and grind them. Now we can add our chopped tomatoes, grind them as well. Now let's transfer this masala into a bowl. Here we still have some tomatoes remaining. We could not grind them all together in the same jar. In the second batch of masala, let's put our leaves in the bottom, that is pudina and coriander leaves. If we add them at the top, it'll take a lot of time to grind. So on the top of the leaves, let's add our chopped tomatoes, grind the masala. Now the second batch of masala is ready as well. Once the pressure cooker whistles, put off the heat and leave it aside. Now let's begin with cooking the 2 batches of masala that we prepared. For this, let's take a vessel and add some ghee. Now here, make sure that you take a big vessel, because once this gravy starts to thicken, it splatters and bubbles rigorously and the whole place would be a mess. So make sure to take a very big vessel. Here I've taken a pressure cooker which is big enough. To this, let's add the 2 batches of masala that we ground. Now give them a good mix. Here you can see the gravy is green in color. We want the color to change to a light brown and all the raw ingredients and the masala to cook well. This will take nearly 30 to 45 minutes depending on the quantity of masala you have. Until then, keep cooking the gravy. Meanwhile, let's also keep our eggs to boil. Now, once the pressure cooker has cooled down, let's open it and separate the chicken stock and meat. Here you must be remembering that we haven't added any water at all while cooking the chicken, but it will release this much of water, so you don't have to add any water when cooking the chicken. Now from this, we will reserve 1 cup of chicken stock to cook the rice. Let's start with cooking the rice. For this, place a pressure cooker in the stove, add sufficient ghee and all the spices that I had shown in the beginning, that is the first set of spices. Now roast the spices. Once the spices have roasted and they are aromatic, add 1 cup of chicken stock and 4 cups of plain water. I am taking 2.5 cups of basmati rice, so for this I'll be taking 5 cups of water. To this also add some salt and wait for the water to boil. Once the water boils, let's add our washed 2.5 cups of basmati rice. Now give them a good mix and wait for the water to nicely reduce and come to a boil. Now here, place the lid over the pressure cooker. Don't properly lock it. Once you reach the stage where the rice has come to the top and the water has nicely reduced, put off the heat, place the gasket and wait, and leave the pressure cooker aside for nearly 20 to 25 minutes. Also, like I have been saying, don't forget to keep mixing this gravy really well. This will take nearly 30 to 45 minutes to reduce and come to this stage. Now there is no raw smell of the ingredients in the gravy. At this point, we'll add the cooked chicken. Here you need to remember the chicken is really well cooked, so we don't want to overcook the chicken. So just leave the chicken in the gravy for 5 to 7 minutes. Keep giving them a good mix. Now the masala and chicken are ready, so put off the heat. At this point, separate some gravy from the chicken, and this we will take to prepare our egg curry. Now take the separated gravy in a kadai, add the remaining chicken stock that we had reserved earlier. You can see the gravy is thick. To this, I'm adding in some more water. Now check and adjust salt as per your taste. You could also add some pepper powder at this point. Now put on the heat and cover the lid and wait for it to boil. Once the gravy has come to a boil, give them a good mix. You can see the consistency of the gravy is good now. At this point, cut the boiled eggs into half and put them in the egg curry. Put off the heat and cover the vessel with the lid. Now we have reached the final stage of our biryani, where we'll be layering our masala and rice. Here you can see the rice is cooked well. Now take a heavy bottomed vessel to layer the masala and the rice. For this, again I'm taking a pressure cooker. In the first layer, I'm adding our masala and some pieces of chicken. Over this, add a layer of rice. Top it with some ghee. Now keep repeating this layer depending on the quantity of masala and rice you have. I have up to 4 layers of rice and masala. I'm finally topping it up with ghee, covering the cooker. Now place the cooker in a stove in a very low flame and heat it for 20 to 25 minutes. Now you can see our biryani is ready to serve. Come, let's serve this. Here, because we are also preparing egg curry, if you don't want too much chicken in your biryani, you can always adjust the quantity of chicken and rice as per your requirement. Please do try out this recipe and let me know in comments. I'll be really happy to know how it turned out for you. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel if you enjoy our contents. We'll be back with more and interesting contents. Until then, bye.